Following up on a story we brought you a few weeks ago, our guest this week is an author, speaker, vlogger, mother of 10 children, and she knows a little something about activism, too, when it comes to educating parents and protecting children. She is the activist mommy, Elizabeth Johnston. It's a pleasure to speak with you today.
Hi, Dr. Duke. It's an honor to be with you.
We really love the work you're doing here at Freedom Project. And one of the things that you and I both have spent a lot of time worried about is this new problem with pornography on our kids' computers. To even say that sounds otherworldly, right? That our kids, public school kids, are finding programs on their computer that allow them to access hardcore pornography, particularly the EBSCO site and the Inspire sites. Take a moment, Elizabeth, and tell us what, in a nutshell, the problem is.
Yeah, it was brought to my attention just a few months ago that EBSCO is a database that is in 55,000 school districts. Think about that for a minute. 55,000 school districts. And EBSCO is basically an online library for schools. It is the school's library online that students are accessing in their student accounts, okay? And these accounts are being, this database is paid for by the schools in order for them to access this gigantic database of educational articles and periodicals. And so our tax dollars are paying for this database. And parents are finding, when they are on their children's school accounts, hardcore pornography, gay pornography, hardcore sex videos through EBSCO, which is sometimes hidden through a different name. One of the names I've heard recently is called Inspire. I know the conservative state of Indiana has it under the name Inspire in their school district. Parents are mortified to learn that when their kids are on their school accounts, they are accessing articles like this. Summer sex hacks you've got to try. Venues where male sex workers meet partners. Prostitution and the good of sex. Great sex starts way before go time. How to navigate a sex party. Can you believe that our tax dollars are paying to fund a database that is pushing hardcore pornography on our children? And parents do not know about it. They're about to know about it. We're about to blow the lid off of this.
Yeah, this needs to be nationwide. When we did the story a couple weeks ago, one of the things that shocked me about it, Elizabeth, is that, one, parents could not access through their code what the kids were able to access. So moms at home who might have been able to access some of what their kids were looking at, they had no ability to access what the students could see, which means your kids could go to school, could access this stuff, but if you tried to use your code, you were frozen out of it. So not only was this not talked to, moms and dads weren't consulted on this, but the schools themselves had rigged it so that even if parents got on, they were going to be blocked from seeing what their kids could see. We have an absolute epidemic in this country of American government schools acting as if they have every right to supersede parents on one issue after another. And perhaps the most shocking way is through sexuality. We know that our young elementary school kids are being exposed to transgenderism. We know that our middle and high school kids are being exposed to not just the biology of sex, but progressive sexual mores and attitudes.
Not only is it not sanitized, it is pandering obscenity to minors. And it's going to stop. The Cherry Creek School District in Colorado just recently had a victory after a year and a half long lawsuit in which the parents were bullied by the school district. They finally decided, the school district, because of the lawsuit that the parents were bringing against them and threatening them with, they finally ended their relationship with EBSCO. An Indiana mother that I know, from 30 minutes of walking into her administrator's office and reading to him the things that I was just reading to you, she said she was blushing, he was blushing, and he literally, on the spot, ended their partnership with EBSCO. He was mortified. He said, I have daughters myself, and I cannot fathom that we have been exposing our students to this kind of garbage and obscenity. And so we are finding that when parents find out about it, they can take action and get it pulled, sometimes rather easily. But the problem has been that, like you said, this has been hidden from parents where they could not find it unless they were signed in through their student, their child's passcode. You must know your children's school passcode. You must access what they are accessing through their passcode and be able to search some of these words like sex and see what comes up. You're going to be mortified, and you need to take this straight to the administrators in your school district and demand that they end their partnership with EBSCO. Please be following the hashtag #DitchEBSCO in coming months. We are about to expose this nationwide, and you're going to see people right and left, just school districts, ending their partnership with EBSCO.
Once you get rid of EBSCO, and I want to talk about getting rid of it in a minute, once you get you break these partnerships, how then do we go back and remind parents that if you were angry about that, then get angry about all the sexualization that's going on in your kids' classrooms and take that responsibility back for yourself?
Absolutely. Well, that is why we launched Sex Ed Sit Out last April, because I got sick of getting information from parents, outraged parents who were tired of their children being indoctrinated in radical leftist gender bending propaganda and pornographic sex ed, obscenity in the classrooms. And so, you know, I'm a homeschool mother. And it's easy for us as homeschoolers to say, our kids are safe, and shame on you for not having your kids safe, and just look down on public schoolers in judgment. But my heart broke for these parents who, for whatever reason, and there's millions of them, who are not going to choose to homeschool, okay? And they're in the system and feel that they are stuck in the system, not to mention that our tax dollars, as a homeschooling parent, my tax dollars are going to fund this stuff. I felt so sorry for these parents who were stuck and felt like they could not get any administrators to listen to them, that they had no right to be pandering obscenity to their children. And so we launched Sex Ed Sit Out. You can go check out the website, sexedsitout.com. And on April 23rd, we decided to hit the public schools in the pocketbook, since they would not listen to parents. Because a child has a certain number of federal dollars over their head. Every child is basically a certain amount of money per day when they are in class. And guess what? When they're not in class, the school loses the federal monies that day for that child. And so schools contacted us after we did Sex Ed Sit Out on April 23rd last year and showed us how their schools were losing hundreds of thousands of dollars because they sat out in droves on April 23rd. We gave them a black eye, but we're not done. We're coming back for more. Because some districts listened and some did not. And this EBSCO being in 55,000 school districts is absolutely unacceptable. We need to give EBSCO a black eye like we have given Teen Vogue a black eye and Netflix and so many other, you know, publishers and publications. People, when they hear EBSCO, they need to think one thing. They need to think pornography. They need to think hands off our kids. You have no right to be indoctrinating our kids and pandering obscenity to them.
What a sad commentary it is that we can't get teachers and school administrators to do the right thing to stop the degeneration of our kids, that all they respond to is the wallet, the pocketbook. They won't listen to pleas and cries of parents. They won't reasonably sit down and recognize that parents are the primary arbiters of their kids' sexual education. What it takes is a hit below in the pocketbook. If you can get them to feel the sting of money, that's when they pay attention. So in order to do that, this protest that we've got you're organizing here to push back against EBSCO and Inspire. How can parents get involved? What do they need to do to join the cause?
After the holidays, probably during the month of February, we have got to get this sex ed and this EBSCO database out of the public schools. And we are probably going to have to do another massive sit out in order to get the attention of the media. Last year when we did this, it became a global movement in four countries, Australia, the UK, Canada, and America sat out in droves on the 23rd because a grassroots movement of mama bears said, we are fed up and you're going to stop pandering obscenity to our kids. We are also working with lawyers, legal teams across the country to close the loopholes in 43 states that presently have loopholes, Dr. Duke, to protect schools so that they cannot be prosecuted for pandering obscenity to minors. In schools, of all places, which should be protected from obscenity, in 43 out of the 50 states, the schools are protected from being prosecuted for obscenity. So legal teams that we are working with are getting those loopholes closed so that in every state, if we ever catch you pandering obscenity to the students, we will prosecute you.
Fantastic. And so we will absolutely get back on board with you. And when you get this all set up, we'll have you back on the show. advertise it far and wide. In the meantime, how do they sign on to your personal site so they can keep tabs on what you're doing?
Sure. Please go to activistmommy.com and you'll see an item there on the click down menu that says newsletter. Sign up to get my newsletter, and we write articles almost every day that are very informative, issues that are very important to parents. And you'll get them right in your inbox, and you don't have to worry about social media censorship because it comes right to you.
Elizabeth Johnston, also known as the Activist Mommy, it's been a great pleasure talking to you today, and we're going to follow up with you on this very important issue, definitely.